If you get nervous, so you're getting tense and you're not going to play at your best in, big games or in life, you're getting stressed. This video is really going to dive into the how-to, not just the fluffy, oh, don't be worried about it and, take action, but actually focus on managing the thoughts and emotions, what those nerves are and what's causing them and what you can do to let that go so you can play with confidence, so you can be at your best and be consistent and perform when that pressure's on or handle stressful situations and navigate life in sport with a lot more ease. So if you don't know who I am, quick, Cassidy Preston, did my PhD in performance psychology because of how much I struggled with nerves, confidence, these things that aren't so obvious. And then therefore now working full-time helping athletes and businesses develop that mindset so that you can perform more consistently as well as to have that well-being. So let's dive into it. This is gonna be, I'm gonna really hype it up here. This is really gonna blow your mind in some different ways. So it's really simple to start off, but it's not always easy. Okay, so very obvious what we want, okay, is to perform, right? We want to perform well. Okay, perform well, and what else do you want? You want to have fun and you want to be learning. These are the obvious outcomes. And what we don't want, which is what happens, is when we don't perform well, right? So we struggle with performance, we're inconsistent, we don't show up when it matters, we get stressed, and we're also therefore not developing. Okay, so those are the polar sides here. And then what's very obvious, and as we highlighted right at the beginning, if you're nervous, okay, you get what? You get tense, you get you're overthinking, you're worrying, you're doubting. I don't mind my spelling. Okay, so thinking, overthinking, worry, doubt, all of these kind of outcomes that we don't want. And therefore you're in your own head, you're thinking about the past and the future. Okay, you're in your mind. It therefore leads to decreased performance, right? Do well in practice, having fun, and then you get to a big game or a big situation or pressure's on, situation changes, we get nervous. Well, why is that? Well, let's kind of make a couple things very clear first. Well, the other side of this is instead of nervous, we're choosing our energy and we're channeling it into being confident. Okay, staying relaxed yet focused. Okay, we are able to stay composed, which is being relaxed. You're able to stay resilient, and you're also definitely able to believe in yourself or have that confidence and believe and take action. So you're very much the way we kind of summarize this. You're present. You're in the flow state. Things are fluid. You're not so fluid. Okay. So in short, that's the obvious stuff, right? Okay, I get this. This leads to that. Okay, we want more of this. Okay, we want less of this. What's causing that? What's the direct correlation here? It's the nervousness and the tension. But these are a result. And let me make that very clear. This is not the how-to. And that's where everybody gets really confused. Oh, how do I perform well? Well, I just got to be confident. No, that's a result in your mindset. This is the result of our mind. Okay? So it is not the how-to. And that's most people's suggestions. Stop doing this. Stop being worried. Just relax. Just be confident. Just believe in yourself. If it was that easy, everybody'd be doing it all the time. Okay, so that's the first thing. We want to see this link. We want to understand this result. And what's very helpful, I want you to do this for yourself right now, assess yourself. Right now, if you're going into a trial or you're going into work or wherever you're going in life, what percentage of your time and energy are you believing, doing, being confident and present versus getting worried, doubting yourself, overthinking, tensing up, and nervous? Think about the past and the future. And it's commonly like it can be, this number can be very high. And a good example is like I had a really high level athlete projected high in the NHL upcoming NHL draft, 90%. Okay, there. And therefore 10% of his time and energy going here. This is common. Like that's pretty, high number here and low number here. And the obvious thing is it doesn't really matter what your number is. You're going to consistently want to get this number down and get this number up. But how? And simply measuring it and actually looking towards it and understanding it is a helpful step. So right there, you've already got something, some takeaways to improve your mindset and allow you to let go. Oh, we clearly want to get here. This is where I'm at. Assess yourself. But what is the how-to? That's what we're going to do. We're going to tackle, make it really clearly laid out. What is the how-to? And it's not just, oh, be confident. Okay. So the how-to, let's start on this side. Why is this happening? Because the better you can understand where this nervousness is coming from, overthinking, worry is coming from, the better you'll get at the how to do to this side. So in short, the best way to often explain this is a fantasy. meaning like you think it's just going to be all sunshine, rainbows. It needs to have to go well. And therefore you have a delusion of the reality of the situation. So we don't have perspective. The other common way to think of this is like, you're not willing to accept the possibilities. Okay. You're really focused on the outcomes, and it's like all about outcomes, and you have to get the team. You got to make it. You got to be the best, and there's no other way. When the facts of the situation are, you're human and you're not perfect, right? So one of those big fantasy delusions is perfection. Okay. There's all kinds of other ways to dive into this. I don't want to spend too much time on it, but I want to make it very clear. We have to look within and understand these concepts, because they're what's causing and are related to this, right? This is the how-to. This is what's going on in our mind. We have some fantasy. Oh, I can't make a mistake. I have to be perfect. Well, if any kind of thought like that happens, of fantasy mindsets that way, that's how you're managing your thoughts, your emotions, you're going to get this. So when you're worrying and doubting, that's feedback that you have some type of delusion, perfection, and you're not willing to accept something. So that means, and we can start to learn and understand, okay, I get this now, and I can start understanding, you know, these tools, which we, you know, our most common way we talk about is the reset routine, which is all about willingness to accept, accepting your situation. It's understanding the situation. Understand you have perspective. You don't think that it's all sunshine and rainbows and I'm just going to score all the time and not get outcomes. I'm just going to be liked by everybody and no one's ever going to, you know, judge me or disapprove. And so you have an aligned perspective of what's reality. And so you also are focusing on growth, okay? And you're focused on learning and growing, which is more intrinsic. Now you do lots of videos on that, and there'll be more coming for sure on this be do have model that helps reinforce this versus overly focused on just what are you gonna have, but how you can learn and grow, which is more meaningful, okay? So there's a lot of how to here. There's other things, you know, good concepts to reinforce off the top would be being open, being curious to learn, being vulnerable. Right? It takes vulnerability to look within and be like, what am I worried about? And to own yourself, to be like, what are the fantasies that I might have? And to accept that you might not get the outcomes and just see the situation, your abilities for what it is. And when you do that, that's helpful. Okay. There's obviously other things like doing breathing helps to calm you down. Okay. Doing imagery and setting intentions versus expectations over here. There's a big one. You can walk in, oh, I expect this and this should happen. All that kind of stuff, fantasies, outcomes that are going to lead more to the side. So hopefully that's made clear. Like, we're not going to overly obviously dive too deep into it, but this is a very big distinction. This is what and how to do these results. These are results, not the how to, okay? We want to learn and start understanding this. And that's what we teach. That's what our courses are all about, our workshops, etc. And so you want to learn more, obviously reach out, and I'll say a little bit at the end, but I want to make that very clear. There's a how-to here. This is managing thoughts and emotions. And so the last thing to make this how-to, and we want to really get clear on this on both sides and pull it all together, is understanding the what, which is energy, right? If you think of this, this is energy, meaning we're going to have energy in different forms. So as an example, you're going to have energy. It's nerves, not nervousness, but the nerves or frustration. These are, another way to say that, is thoughts and emotions. That's energy, right? I go talk to a hockey player and I go, you got a lot of energy about playing basketball tomorrow? No, I don't care. Because they don't care. Like, because that's not their value system. It's not what their energy going towards. So we have energy based on what we value and what's meaningful to you. And so if you're having energy, what then matters is the choice of what you're going to do with this what. And the choice is go this way and channel it that way, or start to foster and channel it this way. And it spirals out of control, and the energy is overwhelming us this way. We have all these fantasies, nightmares, expectations. Okay. And therefore, at least that's what those feelings and results in our mindset of worry and doubt, and therefore leading to these outcomes. Okay. And these are in a way like the actions. Okay, how we act. Are we being fluid and struggling to perform and stressed? Okay. I'm writing it in here now. You're getting to really see my writing. Okay. So the point and the big takeaway here is we want to have choice on the what, right? It's a choice and a habit you get to build to channel and embrace and grow, or not embrace, and learn and have perspective, so that we can be more confident and resilient and believe and get this number up. And now one thing to make very clear about these numbers, I like to just quickly draw, it doesn't really matter again where you are. What matters is where you're going. Okay. And it's never about, oh yeah, now I'm just out here all the time. I'm 100% or I'm at 90%. And even if you're at 90%, believe and do, you're at 10, you get up to 90. Are you happy with being at 90? And like, oh, it's okay. I like worrying and doubting 10% of the time. This is something you can constantly monitor and work on. This is something you just keep doing. It's like your physical health. You got to keep, this is what you do. You don't just become fast and healthy. And that's the result in the suggestions. You do the things that lead to your physical health. Well, this is the same with our mindset, our mental, you know, well-being and our mindset to perform and be at our best. And so when we can see this and understand this clear difference and start understanding this is a result, not the how-to, and we get what the how-to is, we become more aware, right? The awareness is a big side of how-to. We can understand what's causing it, learn to have the channel, the what, the energy, and have the choice to go here, build this up as a habit, start doing this more. Now, the last thing that I'll pull this all together, guess what happens after you have this action? Let's say you perform well. Well, it loops back. It's not the best diagram right now. I'll make it nice for later, but it loops back. And what you'll see is like, now you've got energy again. You perform well, so you scored, people liked you. And what are you going to do with that energy? Sometimes like, well, now I expect and should and have to and need to do this. So then what? We start to worry, doubt, or we're overthinking, a little distracted, don't perform well. Again, those actions loop back. And then you have the choice. How are you going to channel it? And so sometimes people are very oscillating between performing well, not performing well. Great day, tough day. I did that a ton as a player. Okay. And we allow our situation and actions to determine our thoughts instead of being aware of them and channeling it and developing these habits, okay, that lead to these outcomes, that lead to these actions and results more tangibly. So that is everything you need to know in a nutshell about managing your nerves. Are these nerves, are you using them and channeling them and having that perspective? And obviously taking action and preparing is a huge thing, but so many times athletes are very prepared, like this player. He's a great player, and he was 90% worrying and doubting. And I'll tell you what, 3 days later, I talked to him yesterday, okay? It was up to, this was down to 20% within 3 days after one 30-minute chat, okay? Learning these concepts, starting to learn about the how-to, and he was already at 80%, okay? And obviously, he wants to keep doing this work and staying focused, and he's interested in doing the programs that we have, whether it's a one-on-one, whether it's our group stuff, whether it's our online course. It teaches you this more intensely. Our group stuff's fantastic. You get weekly reminders of the how-to. You get to engage. Because guess what our society's teaching us? Our society is developing fantasies. You should do this, have to do that, need to do this, always focusing on outcomes. It's not teaching us these things that we need and are important to understand and are part of having this healthier mindset, of having this confidence, presence, flow, so you can perform at your best. So if you're interested in any of those, there'll be a link below. We actually have a great way for you to be able to apply, and we have lots of special discounts. So that's currently going on. Definitely encourage you to take advantage if you haven't already done so. There's great programs out there. Obviously, comment, reach out with anything, subscribe, all that fun stuff. I love doing this stuff. This is, you know, very meaningful to me. Would love to have you in our groups and help people continue to learn and grow in all areas of life. Definitely. Lots of athlete options, and we're doing more business stuff too. So reach out with any questions, and we'll see you in the next video.